Hello, neighbor, and welcome to the program that is brought to you by Rock City Harvest Church.
And all the friends and partners of this ministry.
I have a question for you, and it begins like this. Do you remember? There's more to the question than that, but I just got stuck on, do you remember? That's a powerful question. Do you remember? You know, I was sitting with a group of people here not long ago, and I'm looking across the room, and there sits this couple. I've known them for years. I'm thinking, what is that guy's name? Hey, do you remember when Coca-Colas were only 6 ounces?
I do.
If you were going,
tell me something.
Yeah. I mean, we're going a long ways back when Coca-Colas were only 6 ounces. You could buy a barge or a knee-high or a RC, and it was 10 ounces.
You are going way back, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what, the other day, our daughter-in-law, Kristen, came in with a six-pack of these little bitty fellers, and she was impressed by them. But when I was a kid back home, just write it down. They ain't getting none of my money. No. I mean, I'm going to the cooler, and I'm going to reach in there and get me the biggest thing they got in there.
Why not? Can you get that, the big one, for the same amount that one, right?
I'm talking about RCs. I usually get an RC.
Really?
Bottled in Brinkley, Arkansas.
Really?
They had it written on the back of the bottle. Bottled in Brinkley, Arkansas.
Same price as that one?
Yeah, but the RCs had one that was 12 ounces.
Wow.
Boy, I'd dig for the big one. I'm telling you.
I'd get that too. Get a 12 ounce instead of
hey,
a 6 for a nickel.
You want to stay tuned because we found a source where you can receive, where you can get 26 ounce Coca-Colas. You don't want to miss this. Right now, Chopper is leading the church in praise and worship. Be blessed. Tell you about the source that we found for these big Coca-Colas.
I can't take a heart that's broken and make it over again, but I know a man who can. Wash it whiter than snow, but I know a man who can.
Some call him Savior,
help you, and your life is out of hand. Oh, I know a man who can. Oh, I know this man who
Jesus said, the thief. He's calling the devil a thief. I've asked Sister Ward to read it, John 10 and 10.
The thief cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly.
Oh, I'd love to talk to you about how God wants you to have the abundant life. No shortages. But let me tell you, if you find the thief, Proverbs 6 and 31 says, but if you find the thief, he shall restore sevenfold, and he shall give all the substance of his house. If he shall restore what he took from you seven times, and if he don't have enough, if he doesn't have enough, then he's got to take everything in his house and give to you. Amen. I'm telling you, God wants you blessed. And there's no reason for the devil to be stealing from you anymore. I heard a song here recently and I recorded. I want you to enjoy it. It says, I'm repossessing my possessions.
I'm repossessing my possessions. Hey, I'm taking my life back. I found out I don't have to be sick and depressed. I don't have to live in lack. You see, I'm a purchase price. I am royalty. I'm supposed to be healthy, wealthy, and blessed. I refuse to live with less. Everything that was good, Satan stole it from me. He had control of my life, had control of my will, but that's all changed. Again, and I'm declaring right now, hey devil, that's my stuff, and you're giving it up in Jesus' name. I'm repossessing my possessions, amen. I'm taking my life back. Oh, I found out I don't have to be sick and depressed. I don't have to live in lack. You see, I'm a purchase price. I am royalty. I'm supposed to be healthy, wealthy, and blessed. I refuse to live with less. Praise God. Would you believe that's me playing that? Way back at Calvary, when he took all the pain, torture, and shame, and he did it just for me. He became a curse so I could live free. Hey devil, that's my stuff, you're giving it up in Jesus' name. I'm repossessing my possessions. Oh, I'm taking my life back. I found out I don't have to be sick and depressed. I don't have to live in lack. You see, I'm a purchase price. I am royalty. I'm supposed to be healthy, wealthy, and blessed. I refuse to live with it. Taking back my possessions. I'm taking my life back. I wish somebody determined that. I found out I don't have to be sick and depressed. I don't have to live in lack. I'm a purchase price. Now I am royalty. I'm supposed to be healthy, wealthy, and blessed. I
Have you ever heard the expression, everything is bigger in Texas? I don't know how long that saying's been around, but been around quite a while. But I remember when I was a kid back home, we heard everything is bigger in Texas. My oldest brother moved out there and found him a wife, and they got married. And we received the news that one day he was bringing his new wife back to Arkansas to visit. Lord, did we ever get excited. Finally, the day came for their homecoming. We were all ready. But something happened that I will never forget. Edward Lee, that was his name. Remember, everything is bigger in Texas. They came in, and after all the excitement kind of died down and everybody kind of got used to him being there, he went out to the car and brought something in wrapped up in a blanket and laid it there on the couch and opened it up. I can recall it like it was yesterday. He took the blanket off, and underneath that blanket were two of the biggest Coca-Colas I had ever seen in my life. I'm telling you, things are bigger in Texas. Our Cokes here are only 6 ounces. Now he's brought two that full 26 ounces. He said, these are the size we have in Texas. Can you just imagine what an impact that had on a little boy like me? I mean, dear God, if this is a sample of what's in Texas, Lord, I want to go there. I want to go to Texas. He said the shelves are lined with them. They're full. He said, not only do we have Cokes, but we have RCs, all different kinds, and they're just this big. I thought, Lord, how wonderful Texas must be. Reminds me of how the children of Israel must have felt when Joshua and Caleb came back carrying those huge grapes. When they were in Egypt, God had promised them a land flowing with milk and honey. And now then, they're bringing back the evidence, proof that it was all that God said it was. Do you know what's amazing? We took those two big Cokes and put them on the shelf. That must have been 50 years ago. And to this day, those Cokes undoubtedly somewhere are still in our family, never been opened. They became souvenirs of the good land, reminders of a bigger world. My brother told me that they had shelves that were filled with these things, but we never opened ours. They became souvenirs, reminders, tokens of a better life, monuments of what was possible. May I submit to you that's how many Christians are today. They've taken the promises of God and they're treating them like they're souvenirs. We've never opened them. We've never activated the word. We believe what God says is true. And when folks come over, we'll talk about how he took them out of the blanket, how we admired how big and wonderful they were. And we just put them up there on the shelf for everyone to see. We believe what God says is true, and we can talk about it until the sun goes down. But did it ever cross your mind to open the bottle up? He told you there was more where that came from. This is the mindset of a lot of us today. We know what is available, but we had rather talk about it than walk in it and possess the land. We missed the whole thing when we had rather have the memory than the experience. We'd rather have the souvenir than the land flowing with milk and honey. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not merely the token God wants us to have. It's not just the milk and the honey God wants you to have. God wants you to have the land that produces the milk and honey and the grapes and the pomegranates and the big Coca-Colas. Don't be afraid. Open the promise. There is more where that came from. Are you ready? Father in heaven, right now I'm decreeing increase above and beyond just the sea. Increase above and beyond just a mental souvenir. Father, this day, the top is coming off. And we're no longer going to watch the blessings, but we're going to participate and enjoy the blessings. Right now, we are releasing our faith, Father, for all that you have for us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. There's still time for you to make it to the house of God and be blessed today. We'd love to have you at Rock City Harvest Church. Our service times begin at 10:30 on Sunday morning, and we will be expecting to see you. Come and be blessed. My name is Arthur Ward. This is my wife, Sandy, and we've got a message for you. It goes like this.
God has big plans for you.